Welcome back. An Oklahoma man has been arrested in connection with a 28-year-old cold case out of Tulsa. Here's One America's Bobby Dupree.
Authorities in Oklahoma announced the end to a decades-long cold case out of Tulsa. Police arresting 62-year-old Tommy Edward Harris on Thursday, charging him with first-degree murder and unlawful removal of a dead body.
Don't think one bit that if you think that you've gotten away with murdering somebody that we're going to be resting.
Investigators say Harris is responsible for killing 31-year-old Kim Marlene McVeigh at a Tulsa home back in May of 1992. The two were among a group of people living there at the time. Officials say it all started when another man arrived to confront Harris, hoping to settle a drug deal gone bad.
He made demands of suspect Harris to give him his meth and or money.
The man, who has since died, engaged in a shouting match with Harris. A gun battle then ensued.
The person there who came to get the drugs took victim McVeigh in a headlock and drug her outside of the residence and into the front yard.
The man used McVeigh as a human shield while shouting at Harris, who was still inside the home. That's when Harris fired his gun through a window toward the man, instead shooting McVeigh in the head. Police say Harris then dragged the woman's body into the house, later burying her remains behind a backyard shed.
We have now been able to provide closure to her family. It was years in the making, but again, at the end of the day, justice, sometimes slow moving, still happens.
Over the years, Harris confessed to multiple people who eventually came forward. Rick Lawrence is a lead investigator and says both he and his colleagues were determined to crack the case.
Because when you're able to help people, especially the mother of this young lady who died, I was able to call her and tell her that her killer had been arrested.
This is the sixth murder case closed since the beginning of the year by the Tulsa County Sheriff's Office. Its cold case task force consists of retired law enforcement officers who volunteer both time and money. They say they have a handful of other cases that are also close to being solved. Bobby Dupree, One America News.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.